Y'all remember that time old walked near home fire?
I remember. I'm pleased to see you awake.
Freya.
It was his choice. I couldn't take that from him.
He saved us all. I'll never forget that.
The family I thought I had was taken from me piece by piece. But there's comfort in the family I've chosen. Your mother was right, you know. You grew into that bow after all. You are a formidable warrior, but even more than that, you have a good heart. Nothing you've endured has changed that. I'm so proud of the man you've become, Atreus.
Thank you. For everything. I should find my father.
You should.
Atreus! Oh, you gave us quite a scare there.
Glad to see you too, Mimir. Listen. I want to thank you.
Oh. What else did you expect from the smartest man alive?
It's not just because you're smart. You listened to me. Mentored me. And, well, you're basically another dad to me.
What?
No. I need you to hear it. I appreciate you so much.
I love you too, little brother.
See you, Mimir.
It's good to see you about, Atreus.
You too, Hildisvini.
And it's nice down here, huh? No loud noises. We're okay. You did so good today, boy. I'm so proud of you. Maybe later, we can find some treats.
Okay. My turn.
Who's that, huh? Yeah, we know him.
Maybe one of these days I'll surprise you.
Oh? You already have.
You were in good hands. Saving us.
I decided it would be better if I wrote the ending myself. You haven't told your father yet, have you?
Told him about what?
Come on. Giant visions? I already saw it. I get it.
Every part of me is telling me this is what I have to do. I just don't know how to say it.
Come with me. I've got something I want to show you. Both of you.
I do not wish to intrude.
This is for you, too.
Atreus, I am glad you are well.
I'm glad you are, too. So, what was the end of the story?
What?
Before Ragnarok. You promised to finish it if I fell asleep.
When Death arrived, he asked why the old man had called for him. Seeing Death before him caused the old man to reconsider his request. After a moment, he asked that Death help him lift the logs onto his back so that he may continue on his journey.
He wasn't ready to die.
He wished to keep living.
There's a lot of smoke out there.
It seems when Asgard fell, pieces of it landed all over the realms. There might still be some Einherjar near them, but that's not what I brought you here to see.
Mother? My shrine in Jotunheim. She destroyed it. She didn't want us to know our fate.
We forged our own path because of her.
She went against her own people. Our people. To protect you. They don't all open. I'm sorry.
Father, I need to talk to you about something. There are other giants out there, and I've got to find them. I think I know where to look, but they're my responsibility. I need to do this alone. I don't want to do it alone, but I need to. It's hard to explain.
Does it frighten you?
Yeah.
That is why you must do it.
Like you taught me. Yeah.
We survived today because of your choices. Who to trust? Who to call friend? Son. Ready.
Remember our promise. Care of him.
you see in there, brother?
Well. One I had never imagined.
And what now?
There is much to do. Much to rebuild. But you join me.
Aye.
We'll see to it. Together.
Probably talk about Gunnar.
We don't need to talk about her. We just need to find her.
But Odin chose her as his new Valkyrie queen. A Vanir goddess, your friend.
Gunnar pledged loyalty to Asgard long ago, and our friendship ended soon after.
What happened?
I made a choice. One she couldn't accept. Kratos. She hates me. She will be a problem for us. Better we find her than she finds us.
And another one for the big boy himself. Skull!
Skull!
Hold a few dozen per camp. Families will stay together, obviously.
Take care, Kratos.
Thank you. I appreciate that. And we'll bring all the supplies we can, although it won't be much.
Don't worry about it. Anyone who's able can head out for extra supplies. Aesir and Vanir.
Together.
General, Lady Freya, Mimir.
My lady.
Shield maidens.
Blessed Thor, have you found the traitor Gunnar yet, dear Freya?
Not yet. Soon.
One final word. We wish to offer condolences.
What for?
For your family. Your brother.
We didn't mean to pry, sister.
It was a lifetime ago. Memories in ruins. I'm surprised there was anything left.
I just wish you had told me. I would have understood.
What's done is done, dear Mimir. I appreciate your kind words.
Huh?
Where to first?
We could take care of any lingering business in the realms.
Or investigate those pieces of Asgard.
Either way, we're with you, brother. Lunda also mentioned there's going to be a get-together to honor Brock's memory at Rab's Tavern in Svartalfheim. I'd like to go.
Mimir, there's something I wanted to ask you about. Hildisfini told me about your visit to secure Hel's army, but was reluctant to elaborate when it came to negotiating with Krasfelder.
Ah, yes. Well, I can see why he'd hold off on such a subject until he saw if we survived the battle.
Mimir, what exactly did you promise the large bird?
Oh, nothing too horrifying.
Another time. We must focus.
Careful, brother. You're covered in Bifrost.
It's going to ram you! Behind you!
The Einherjar will continue to be a nuisance for the realms.
Only if we do nothing. The realms will never heal if they remain.
How many more?
One way to find out.
Something is on your mind. What is it?
Freyr's sword. I'm glad he got it back.
Odin stole it?
Not quite. It couldn't be stolen. It had to be given freely. Freyr had it forged in his younger days, imbued with its own motives and passion. For centuries, he swore he would only ever set it down in death or upon meeting the love of his life. Both he and the sword were romantics, you see.
It is gone.
I think the Norns are quite done with us, brother.
Strange. There are still signs of the World Serpent all over the lake. But we saw him disappear at Ragnarok.
I can only mean the legend was true all along. That blow from Thor sent Jormungandr straight back in time. A younger Jormi, fresh from Jotunheim, would grow into the serpent we know.
When we first met the snake, you said that he found Atreus familiar. Perhaps they met in Jotunheim.
Perhaps so, brother. We'll have to ask the lad for that story when we next see him. As I was saying before about Klaasvelka, it's just that she'd like to retire.
Retire? Hell's Eagle wants to retire?
Not now.
No!
Don't understand why they keep fighting. Can't they sense Odin is dead?
They are soldiers. They will always be loyal to him, alive or dead. It is a matter of honor.
Yes, they will continue to follow his orders and keep the realms under his thumb.
Not for long, they won't.
Jormungandr attacked Thor in Asgard. It seemed personal, somehow. But there's no way they could have met before that, is there?
I've been pondering that, and I have a theory. We know the lad spent his time in Jotunheim learning soul magic. Perhaps the serpent figured in.
You mean Atreus placed some other giant soul into him? Someone who already hated Thor to begin with?
Exactly! Though that doesn't narrow it down much, I grant you. I wonder if Jorm even remembers after all this time who he once was.
Were you serious before, Mimir? Rastelger truly wishes to retire?
Indeed. And don't ask me what he expects to do with her free time. I assure you, there is no reassuring answer.
Can she even do that? Not be hell?
Apparently so. She just requires relief. Someone else to step in and become hell, as it were.
Not exactly an office many would wish to occupy.
Aye. Terrible weather, infinite hours, and the possibility of unleashing terrible mischief on the realms if they're careless. Or worse, if they aren't completely trustworthy.
But if she were to leave without a replacement?
Complete chaos, yes.
Well, I'm sorry I asked.
Hi, Kratos.
Would have been a shame to have left that behind.
What is wrong?
No, nothing. It's just... Don't know if you've heard, but we're gonna say goodbye to Brock in Svartalfheim.
A funeral?
Yeah. We're meeting at Rab's Tavern in Nidavellir.
We will be there.
Ragnarok armor's on the house. We'll call it a commemorative piece. Oh, what can I do for a goddess?
Impressive.
What do you need, handsome? Let me get my forging hammer.
Profane alternate lyrics to my ballad. Absolutely disgusting. But wish I could remember some of them.
The paperwork that man created for me. I had to build a chest just for his violations. A big one.
I taught him 20 different ways to cold forge a bolster. Once, he taught me a slightly easier method of wire pulling, and from that day on called me his apprentice.
A true asshole he was. Gods, I'm gonna miss him.
Aye. Y'all made it. Just about to send him off.
I have met many on my travels. You are one of the few I would call friend.
I always thought you were one of the dumbest creatures I'd ever met. Didn't expect you to be the bravest, too.
This world is a darker place for your leaving it.
We're taking him to the Sverd Sands. It's, in the wetlands near the ferry. We'll wait for you there. Near the little shop I'm running out in the Alpine Desert, there's something y'all are probably gonna want to see.
Thank you. Careful, brother! You're covered in Bifrost!
I just had a thought. With Asgard destroyed, where will the Inhyar go?
Valhalla exists both inside and outside of Asgard. Who knows what became of it?
Aye. Suppose they'll have to find rest somewhere.
Changed. Sewn some mourning garb. We're not dressed properly.
We're fine. The dwarves don't typically require formal wear at funerals.
Brock certainly would not.
Perhaps.
Phil, now you've got me thinking of what I might look like with some jewelry around my neck stump. Maybe some gold woven into my beard. That'd be quite fetching, eh?
Thanks for trying.
There they are, brother.
Oh, come on, surely he'll be along. It's his brother.
Let's hope so. Loss can do things to a man. You made it. We can begin.
love you.
It's bigger, the more you take away.
To all things housed in her silence, nature offers a violence, the bear that keeps to his own line, the wolf that seeks always its own. Is a harsher winter holds the parent forced to eat its young before it grows. Every bird gone unheard, starving where the ground is froze. The winter sunrise, red on white, like blood upon the snow. Blood upon the snow. nature's given. She takes all things back from the living. I've walked the earth, and there are so few here that know how dark the night and just how cold the wind can blow. I've no more hunger now to see where.
I don't know if there's anything beyond the light, afterlives after afterlives or what have you. But if there is, well, I imagine he's causing one crazy ruckus there.
Forgive Sindri, he's just, I mean, you know.
I wrote that dirge for him.
What's it called?
Something profane.
He wouldn't have it any other way.